Hello everyone and welcome to this video where we are going to take a look again at the best system for pumping. This is part two of the video that was released yesterday, and really what we're going to do is take a look at some other systems, some other methods, and other ways of connecting the two chambers that we are pumping. Now, as we know and as we discussed in the last video, there's a ton of different methods to do everything in this game, and just like real life, how do you find the best system? You're left with a bunch of different options, and until you really test it out, it is kind of like an unknown question mark, let's call it. You don't really know what you're getting into, and I really love all the comments and all the engagement that all of you are giving, because really, I can think of so many scenarios, but then I get other people saying, oh, try this, try that. And really, I love it. That is engineering at its finest. That is testing all kinds of hypotheses and coming up with conclusions. So without further ado, let's begin. For the first set of trials, we are not going to use the air, compressed air. We're just going to use our simple cases. And as you can see here, I've colored in the different filters, but I want to take that one step further actually. So what I'm going to do is orange is going to denote if it's a mixture. So here we have both air and water going through, or diesel I think, going through this pump. In this case here, this is a mixture, and then our air is escaping and purely our liquid continues on. Okay, in our next case, you have the mixture, which is orange, come into this. Oh, or rather you don't, because you first off, right off the bat, have this filter here. So this filter will prevent anything from going past this but liquid. So really you've already isolated out the liquid, and this setup, you could tell right away, it doesn't really make sense. So just by using this, you've already taken out your mixture. You've filtered it, you've prevented it from even coming in. So I'd say this one doesn't have to get considered. Instead, what we can do is remove this and color the whole thing orange, because pretty much what you have is a combination of the water and the diesel going through this with some of the pressure being bled off. So you're still actually putting in into this chamber a mixture, just like in that first case, but you're bleeding off some of the air. In this next case here, you have a mixture coming through, and then you have a mixture actually leaving with air escaping. So it's the opposite of what we just did on this side. So that's gonna be interesting. Then if we continue on here, you get a mixture going here, coming through, and it hits this point at which your air will leave and your diesel will continue on. Now this, I predict, I think this will probably bottleneck and the pump, because I think the pump can pump more than the filters can release. So this part is gonna get backed up or clogged up with our mixture, and it's not gonna know what to do. So we'll see if that actually works or not. In the next example here, we get our mixture coming through, we get air leaving, okay. Mixture keeps going through, and then yeah, this also won't work. Just looking at this, you'll end up with your liquid being filtered right here instead of beforehand. So I think our pump is going to clog up. Now will it clog up and release from this? We're going to find out. I'm going to leave this case. And on this one, I did a weird hybrid again. So you have this happening, and really there should be no air here. And you know what, just for fun, because why not, let's put this on this side and see what happens if we have pretty much pressure or air relief valves everywhere and our liquid filters as well. So we'll see exactly how this one works. So let's load this up and see. We can go ahead and start the trials, and as you can see right off the bat, there are ones that are doing differently when it comes to the speed, so that is clearly good. We're just gonna wait until our base case hits around 5,000, and then we'll stop it and take just a quick look at what kind of results we're getting, and then we'll move on to the rest of them. But as you can see, we're almost hitting 4,000 here, and soon enough we're gonna be there. But what's quite interesting to note right now is, yes, we don't have any system to drain the pressure that's building in this bottom chamber, and yes, we will address that in a test that's going to come later on in this video. So first things first, here we hit 5300 almost, which is our base case. We're quite aware of that one. Then here we have almost 4000. That was our previously favorite setup, where purely liquid goes through this filter and then pump. Now over here we have still a mixed system, but a mixed system that has a pressure release on one side, and here we have a mixed system that has a pressure release on the downstream side. So if we take a look here, you can actually see that the one with the filter on the downstream side is pretty much the same. Well, not 100% the same. This one's actually 0.3 if you look at the decimal point, whereas this one is point something, and it's slowly draining because the pressure is releasing itself. So this one's 0.3 and this one is 0.16, so this one's slightly less. But what we have here is still a higher number, quite interestingly enough. So this mixed system is still faster than our purely filtrational system here, but it is not quite as fast as a purely mixed system. So the mixed systems will be interesting because you're going to have pressure building up inside them, whereas in these other ones they're having lower pressure, as you could see. So this one specifically only allows the liquid in, whereas this one allows both in. So this one, the pressure is going to increase much faster. Obviously here the pressure is also going to increase because our gas has nowhere to go, so as you pump more liquid in, it starts to fill up. So we will address that. But what I do want to note is these ones here. Now, moving on to these next cases here, this one is still working and doing slightly okay, or doing slightly pretty good, actually, not slightly. This one is where we had the filters after, but this is my worry that that one is going to end up clogging up because you may not be able to pump or push the stuff out of the filters as fast as the pump is working. So that's third last. We're at 5200 here, so it's just less than our base establishing case. Here we have just less than 4,000, similar to this one here. Not exactly the same, so getting a different number. But what is interesting here is we're actually letting everything pump through. And again, I'm pretty sure this one is going to clog up just because you don't have nowhere for your air to escape. You're putting mixed fluid and liquid into the pump. And then our weird last case that has all the different air escapes is at almost 4,000, sorry. Again, I'm not too confident in that one. I just kind of threw it in. Now, we will leave this test and let it just run its course and see what kind of things and results we get. But I'm going to leave this and check in on it in some time here. It's been roughly 25 minutes since we started this experiment, and we take a look at our control case. We've almost hit 30,000 here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop this right now. So let's just say we're at 29,000 here on the control. On the next one, which we know happens to be slower because it is pumping in only the liquid, we're at 21,500. So here we have 29, so keep in mind here is a good amount less. We're at 8,000 liters less. Here we have 27,000 liters, so it is slower than our control case. And here we have 29, so these two have matched them fully. So the first one being the control and the fourth one have been matched in the speed. Now granted, we are pumping in both fluid and gas in all three of these cases, so keep that in mind. Which I do know that some people are saying that you have to pump in only liquid into the selling points, otherwise you break the pumps or break the system. So you'd have to use this setup if you wanted to pump into the selling points. But these are interesting creations here. So here we have 27,000, 29,000. Now this one is very, very interesting. Where I thought that it would stall out, this one actually seems to be doing the best, which is interesting, but not totally unexpected in a sense that, yeah, the mixture goes through up until this point, and then it forces the liquid here and it forces the gases out. So it still jumbles it up at the highest speed possible, and then it forces this through. So it actually has 29,200, whereas this has 29,200. Now this has 40, this one has 36. So over the span of the 25 minutes, it only has a difference of 20 liters or so, or 15 liters, and this one is delivering mixed, and this one is delivering purely the liquid form into this chamber. Now we can actually verify this. If we look at the pressure here, it's 2.4, and this is 3.5, which is obviously telling us that in this case, we actually pumped out a good amount of the gas into that chamber, whereas here we didn't. Now, if we look at this, we get 1.8, but obviously it is a much lesser amount, so there's no direct comparison, but in this case, we in theory should not have added any liquid to this chamber here because it should have all been expelled out. Now, if we go to the next one, this one stalled out. So this one did not make it, in fact, and the reason why is because it gets filled up here with the mixture, and then it starts to slowly ease out and ease forward. So this one, it stalled out and then it kind of goes, and then it stalls out and it goes. So this, do not use this. This last one, as expected, we're at less because we have all these pumps. It's an inefficient, or all these filters, it's an inefficient system. Like, you're crossing two liquid filters, you're going through two of these, or three of these gas filters. So we're at 21,000 here. So we're at a very similar amount in this one as we are in this one. And presumably what it's telling us is that this pump here is this filter, this system at the very base is doing all the work and liquid's coming through, and we have this system replicated here. So all this stuff downstream doesn't do anything. You already have pure liquid going through the pump here, so these are just totally unnecessary and in fact slow things down. So it's doing just slightly slower, like 10 liters less than this one over the grand scheme of things, which is nothing, but I would not use that system. So the surprising winner in this, well, at least surprising but not totally unexpected, because I said that it would not work, but it seems that it is in fact this one. So we're pumping everything through and then we're filtering what we want, rather than filtering fully before and then the pump has a reduced amount of flow. In this case, it seems like we're jamming this little T section here with everything and then it goes out of these vents. Like, I'd be quite curious actually to see how much this vent here releases versus the vent in the second case, because in theory this one should be releasing more because we're actually pushing all that gas in this and shoving it out, whereas here it's just kind of coming out as it gets stopped by the filter. So interesting results in this case, with my favorite out of these here being this one, which we just mentioned, because only liquid comes out of it. Even the system that we originally in the previous video said was good, which had this setup, it is slower, so this one doesn't really compare. In the long run, I wonder if this would work and be sustainable, but so far, these two ones where you only get the liquid are very interesting. These ones are just like a hybrid on the base case, which is just pumping both things. Here we just have relief valves, so there's some pressure being released, which is good for sure, but it's not really helping us in a sense that we're still pumping mixed liquid in. So I like this one the best. And then obviously these two, like the ones that are only pumping liquid out. The next logical thing to test would be to try now with these tanks up here, but I went ahead and not only do I want to try with these tanks, but I want to also vent out this, call it end chamber, so we're not just blindly accumulating pressure in there, at least as much as we can. With this now, we should be somewhat releasing the pressure from there. I know it's not very fast. Maybe you'd need a bunch more of these vent holes, maybe even a pump. So obviously this setup doesn't test every possible parameter. There's, like I said, tons of options here, tons of different setups. You can try this with different amount of intakes. You could try all sorts of stuff. I will say that I did try the large port, this one, but this pump, like a large pump, was not able to do very well with this style port, so I just want to throw that out there. But is one enough? Maybe, probably not, to be honest. I think two would have been a better number, but let's just try with one single port and one single pump and these setups, where when we turn on our button here, it's also going to release this compressed air. Now, the amount of compressed air that there is in these tanks here does not really match the amount of volume that we have inside this chamber. Like, remember how I did in the other video, we had, I think it was 8,000 liters. And for that 8,000 liters, we had 1,000 liters of air. This is a much smaller ratio, so is it going to help a lot? Probably not. I wouldn't think so, but regardless, let's just see what happens and kind of go from there, because this test in itself will gauge how the previously tested arrangements actually do work with a system that has a release and that has a little bit more pressure built up inside that upper chamber, or the chamber we're trying to pump from. So I'm going to start it up and step back and kind of watch the numbers here. As you can see, things are rising. Now I'm quite curious, ones that have a vent port for air, like this here, and even this one here, and these ones down here, is all of our compressed air just escaping out of this, or is it actually helping and pushing through here? So maybe when you have this relief valve on this side here, it doesn't really make it into this, but maybe it does, and I'm sure some of it does, because regardless, it's pushing a lot of that liquid into the pump at least. So if we turn it off now, we could see here on our base case, we reached just over 10,000, or I mean just under 11,000 liters. And because we are venting the air, you could see that this is slowly dropping, not very fast. Eventually it will become atmospheric pressure, but right now we're getting 10,000. So to compare with our other example, we just have almost 8,000. So it's still less, as expected, no big deal. Now here, like I said, almost 11, this one's almost 8. Here we're at almost 10, or pretty much exactly 10, whereas this one are just over 10. So with our compressed air setup, this one where we just have still the combined mixture getting in, but just with a different position of this relief valve, or the air relief, it is getting us a different number. The higher, slightly higher number, or almost 800 liters higher, is actually the air relief on the downstream side of the pump rather than on the upstream side. Now this one here is 10,800, and this one here is 10,758. So almost behind the base case example, but keep in mind this one is the one where we are purely pumping in liquid. So that is very encouraging, I will say. It's very encouraging because we're not, pumping in a bunch of air from that tank. And you can see here that the pressure inside that bottom chamber is almost 2 atmospheres, whereas here it's 1.3. Now this one here is gonna stop, and this one here doesn't really matter, we've concluded. So really just looking at these ones here. Now if I continue going, obviously some of them that had the this on the upstream side of the pump may have released some of that pressure, so the pause in the test couldn't have been too great for some of those. But regardless, I just want to test the actual longevity of this example, so I'm going to leave it on for a bit and see what kind of results we get here in a few minutes. I left it on here for around 5 minutes, and we're getting interesting numbers. Now the first thing that I want to see here is my base case here that just has the pump, and it ends up with a mixed fluid. We're getting just under 30, so I'm going to actually stop it when it hits 30, and then we're going to be able to compare the rest of them. But keep in mind, now it is the base case, but it also has a little air vent, so it is venting out, or trying to vent out, some of that air that's building up inside that bottom chamber there. So here we are, almost at 30. I'm just going to hit stop here, and then we'll take a look. Now I do have some guesses here, and pretty much the guesses are that we're going to be getting close numbers for some of these cases, specifically here. But first, okay, 30,000 on that one. This one here is 23.3. Now, which one is that? That is the one that we liked before, or that I liked in the previous video. Still is a solid contender, I will say. If you are trying to pump pure liquid, this is a solid contender, but it is not the fastest. So, as before, I will say, if you just want your easiest possible scenario, just use a pump. No filters, nothing. But you can't use this when you're trying to sell your diesel or jet or oil or whatever into the gantries. You got to use a system that ends up with pure liquid. So this one is good for just ease of use. Okay, this one here is 7,000 liters less, so I wouldn't really recommend that now, actually, after having done our tests in this video compared to our previous one. Now these two are interesting because they get us similar numbers to this, but the problem is they're still just mixed fluids. Like, you're still pumping in both liquid and gas. So would I personally decide to use one of these two over just a single pump without anything? Probably not, to be honest, because the advantage isn't there. It's not there in speed, and it's not there in the fact that you're mixing or removing the mixture of the fluid in this example. So I probably won't use these ones, even though they work. You know, you put that on, you'll end up with a system that works, but you're still getting mixtures. Okay, now our new favorite, or my new favorite, very similar to our case that had pumped mixture, except now we actually cleaned it up and we are just pumping in the liquid in this tank. So this is here my new favorite, and then this one's broken, and this one is complicated and useless and ends up being similar to this system, which, so it's identical to the system. Like we said, our first old favorite is there with two random and unnecessary air filters. So that is quite interesting information just off the bat here, because now we see, while there is many different configurations, there's some that don't necessarily lend us an advantage. As a final test for this video, I've now developed a couple of alternative systems for our new base case, which was my previous favorite one, or the favorite one from just the last test here. So it is quite simply a mixed solution, or liquid and gas, coming from the port, going past the pump, and then after the pump, you have the gas being expelled, or the air being expelled, and the liquid only entering this chamber. So this is now our base case. In the previous test, just a few minutes ago here, this was the favorite. So this is now establishing case. What I've done was in this part here, I've now just added a air filter on the upstream side as well. So we have an air filter on the downstream and an air filter on the upstream. My thought for this is maybe some of the air can leave here and some of the air can leave after, and possibly this could be an optimal setup, but we'll see. So this is one option. The next one is pretty much the base case with four ports on the other side, just allowing air to leave. So whatever we are adding, we're adding in liquid here. We're not adding any air mixture. We're adding a pure liquid, but obviously as it takes up space, these filters will push the air out and kind of relieve the pressure. So there should be less pressure buildup. So we'll see exactly how much play the pressure makes in this case. But these are big tanks, so I'm expecting not a lot. If they were smaller tanks and we were hitting 100 fairly fast, I think this would. On the next one, just to compare four ports that are dumb or, you know, non-whatever powered, and then here you have a pump that's actually pumping air out. So we have here on the upstream side, we have a air valve or gas relief valve, and we're just pumping air out. So we're in essence creating a vacuum here probably as this happens or as this goes. So we'll see how the vacuum state differs to just having passive vents. That's the word I was looking for, passive. So again, all these systems on this side are the same. Now here, I'm testing out whether this pump actually could be more efficient with two ports coming out of it. So one port sucking the mixture from this tank, it goes through the pump, comes here, and it'll slowly leave the system here in addition to the liquid leaving into this chamber. So we'll see how that works. On the next test, I actually have two valves or two ports, and I have two air filters relieving the pressure. So we'll see how that compares with these two sets. And last but not least, this case, what I did is I actually have two ports pulling from the tank and the two ports on this side here, just like this one. So I want to see maybe like what is the capacity of one single pump. Is one port enough? Is two ports in, two ports out good? Like, is this going to make any difference, or is it just going to bottleneck it? So this is the final test for this video, and we'll see out of our favorite example here which one is ending up with the best values. Start up the test and we'll sit back and watch what happens here as we hit some milestone marks here. I've not looked at any of the data, but I'm going to stop this as our first case hits around 10. So 10.2 thousand liters, and that one is the one that we had in the previous video. So this is our new establishing case. We're at 10,200. This next one, we're at 10,100. So the difference is we had a fluid or gas port on this side. Now, presumably, what's happening is this compressed air is pushing into this, and the compressed air is just escaping from this rather than pushing the fluid through the pump. So in these, with these two examples, this first one is still doing better. Okay, that makes a little bit of sense. That's 10.1, this is 10.2. Now this one is 10.234, 10.237. So here we're doing just 3 liters less, which is interesting because we have four vent ports. So if we look here at the pressure, this one is at 1.3, this one's at 1.25. So this one actually did a little less, which is quite interesting. Now this one had 10.230, and the number's fluctuating a little bit because of the pressure as well, but this one has the same number, 10.238, and this is the one that had a pump. So in this case, we actually have a less pressure inside there. Eventually it'll get to a vacuum state, but right now it's not. So if we go back to here, 10.238, this one is 10.278. Interesting. So that is the highest, 10.278, and that is this one here. So we're actually able to put more through with these dual vent or dual ports. And if I go to this one, we're putting out less. So this one here is letting us have more, whereas this one here is actually giving us less. Why is it giving us less? Well, the air pressure may be escaping the system and not pushing as much fluid through, is what my guess is. But here we have the highest number, and here is actually the less, or the least. And over here, 10.771. Okay, so that one is by far the largest amount. And what we do have there is two ports coming out of the tank, and two down here. Now, actually, that actually brings an interesting observation. This case was getting us higher numbers than the middle case. So the right case, where we only had one port out, was getting us a better result than having two ports out. So maybe in this case, we should also try to have just one single port out. Now, the risk being, maybe in a longer test or a longer duration, it'll actually fill up with the combined mixture and stall out the system if we have the one port, but it may be worthwhile to take a little gander at that. I did go ahead and remove the one example that had the four fluid ports, or four gas ports out, and just put that one example that I just said. So we have two in, two out, with one single gas vent there. And we're going to be able to compare then to the ones that have the two and the ones that have one. So like, we'll be able to compare the new one that I just put with this system that has two ports out, and this one here that has two, two, and two. This one has one, two, and two. Hopefully I'm making sense. Anyways, I will leave this be and check back when we have a bit higher numbers, because I do want to see if that one example here, where we have two in, one gas out, and two out, so 2-1-2, if this one's going to be the most efficient, just from what we kind of looked at a little bit earlier. So in our base case here, where we just had kind of the system that we tested last time, we hit 30,000. 30,000 liters we hit. Now, comparing it with the next one, 30,000 as well. So that is the one where we had an upstream and downstream gas filter. And it's a little less. It's like 25 liters less. So not a huge deal, but it adds two unnecessary parts and it doesn't gain you anything. So this one is the best out of these two. Moving on to this one, you'll be very surprised, or maybe not, to find that we are 3,500 liters higher. And that is because we have two outlet pipes, or two inlet, two outlet, and one single gas release valve. So this one is doing excellent. Now, compared it to this, we have 11 liters higher than our base case. This one here being where we created a vacuum. So if we check this pressure versus this pressure, you could see that this pressure is lower. So in this case, the vacuum gained us an extra 11 liters over the span of 30,000. That's not a huge win, I guess. So you're better off, in my opinion, with the simpler one than just 11 higher, but that's just my opinion. Here we have 7 higher. And what do we have here? We have the dual outlet. So one single in, two out. So this system gained us 7 liters, so not a huge deal. But what is interesting is this last one. Before we get the last one, we do have this one here, which is 29,800 something something. And what it is we have on both of these, we have one single inlet and we have two outlets with a combination, either one or two of the gas release valves. So the one with two gas release valves and two outlets actually got us the least amount of liquid transferred, but by, it's like 100, 120, so not a huge amount of liters lost, like 100 liters lost or less, whatever. But again, you've added an extra complication. You've added two valves, you've added two outlets for nothing, for no gain. So this one is unnecessary, of course. Now over here, this one is our first one that we were happy with, and pretty much what it gets us is two pipes in, two gas out, and two pipes out. And this one is getting us 33,200. So between this one and this one is 33.2, this one is 33.5 almost. So the answer is yes. If you have one single vent on a double in, double out, that is your most optimal system by around 3,000 liters. So that's a substantial amount compared to just having one pipe in, one pipe out, one outlet. So these two compared are the best. So I will say that this experiment yielded some interesting results. Now, of course, sometimes it's not the easiest way to implement all this stuff, but it is interesting to note what kind of things you can get. Now, what it would be interesting for a next test is to have three in, three out, for example, because at some point this pump, there's a law of diminishing returns, and this pump won't be able to keep up with what we're trying to pump in. So maybe two is the optimal amount, but so far what we're getting is this is better than a single one. So that means this pump is clearly able to pump through this system with ease. I'd be interested also to know if having more outlets and less inlets, or less inlets, more outlets, you know, switch that around type thing. Also, we did learn a combination of having this vacuum does help us, even though just a little bit, as you can see behind me here, it gained us, you know, 11 liters over the span of 30,000. So not great, but that may help us in a case where we have more, in a case where we actually let this pump work higher, or if we put a gas tank that has nothing in it and it sucks the air out of it rather than pumping it out, maybe that would be a faster system. So there's some things that can be tested. Let me know in the comments as well what type of things you'd like to see perhaps, but I think that this test actually gained us a good amount of information on what we're kind of dealing with here and some future tests to be done. But I mean, I would love to find the optimal solution, the best one, but I think even now we found very good viable solutions that we could actually use moving forward, and I don't think any of these are particularly bad in any case. So thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for more videos. Got more creations on the way, all kinds of things on my Discord server, and as always, happy Stormworksing, everyone.